So students, before starting question number 2, I want to tell you about vector theorem. What is a vector theorem? The polynomial x minus a is a vector of the polynomial p of x, if and only if p of a is equals to 0. That means in a vector theorem, we will always have our p of a means polynomial. When we will put the value of x, like when we take x minus a equals to 0 and we have x equals to a, when we put our value of x in our polynomial, after putting the value of x, we have 0 as our remainder, like our remainder is 0, then this is called the vector theorem. The vector theorem tells us that the remainder is always equals to 0 when we put our value of x in our polynomial. So this is the whole vector theorem. Now we are going to solve question number 2. If x plus 2 is a factor of 3x square minus 4kx minus 4k square, then we have to find the values of k. So x plus 2 is the divisor. We have to take it equals to 0 and we have to put the value of x in this polynomial, then we have to find the value of k. So let's start solving it. We have x plus 2 as a divisor. This is our divisor, and our polynomial is 3x square minus 4kx minus 4k square. This is our polynomial. So first we will let our polynomial equal to p of x. Now we will put our divisor, we will take our divisor equals to 0. So x value will be minus 2. We will put our value of x in this polynomial term. So it will be p of minus 2. 3 minus 2 whole square minus 4k into minus 2 minus 4k square. So we have put our value of x in our polynomial term. Now we will solve it. Minus square is plus. When we take the square of minus, it is plus. Minus 2 whole square is plus 4 minus. Minus minus plus, so it will be 4. It will be minus minus and plus 4, 2 times 8k minus 4k square. 3, 4 times is 12. Now we have this type of equation, like we have 4k square, we will arrange it 8k plus 12. Now we will find the factors of this equation. We will take it equals to 0 and we will find the factors of this equation. Then we will have the k value. So this is our expression. We have to factorize it. We will apply the midterm breaking method on this expression. Firstly, we will take minus sign common from this equation, so it will be minus 8k minus 12 equals to 0. Then this minus will solve with the 0 and it will be like this. So now this is the expression we have to apply on midterm breaking method. Now we will multiply 4 with 12, it will be minus 48. And we have to from there we come to know that we have to subtract the two factors which we are going to write, and here we have minus, so with the biggest term we should have minus sign. So we need minus 48, and don't write minus here. We have to find two factors by which we will have 48, and by subtracting the two terms we should have, not 12, we should have 8. From this sign we know that we have to subtract the two terms or we have to add the two terms with the constant. We will see the sign with the constant. So now we have think about the factors. We will use 4 and 12 because by multiplying 4 and 12 we have 48, and by subtracting 4 and minus 12 we have minus 8. So we need minus 8 here. So we will use these factors, plus 4 and minus 12. Now I am going to write it. It will be 4k square plus 4k minus 12k minus 12 is equals to 2. Now we will take 4k common. The remaining term will be k plus 1, and minus 12 will be common. K plus 1 will be the remaining term. Now k plus 1 is also common, so we will take k plus 1 as common, and our remaining term is 4k minus 12 is equals to 0. Now if we take k plus 1 is equals to 0, the k value will be minus 1, and if we take 4k minus 12 is equals to 0, it will be so our k value are 2. K is equals to minus 1 and k is equals to 3. Now class, we are going to start solving our question number 3. Without actual long division, determine whether x minus 2 and x minus 3 are the factors of this polynomial, yes or not. Acha, putting x minus 2, the value of x minus 2 in this expression, if our remainder is 0, then this will be the factor, x minus 2 will be the factor of this polynomial, and when we will put the value of x minus 3, we will take it equals to 0, then we will put the value of x in this expression. If our remainder is 0, then x minus 3 will be the factor of this expression. X minus 2 equals to 0 and our x value will be plus 2. Now we will put our value of x in this expression. It will be p of 2 is equals to 2 cube minus 12 2 square plus 44 into 2 minus 48. 2 cube will be 8 minus 12 into 4 plus 88 minus 48, and 8 minus 48 plus 88 minus 48. Now we will solve it. So after solving this whole all terms, we have 0. So from this we know that x minus 2 is the factor of p of x. What is p of x? P of x is this. We don't have to write the full expression, we will just write p of x. Now we will take x minus 3 equals to 0. It will be now we are checking for x minus 3. We have checked for x minus 2, this is the factor of this p of x. Now we are checking for x minus 3. So x minus 3 is equal to 0 and we have x equals to 3. We will put p of 3 equals to 3 power cube minus 12 into 3 square plus 44. Student, these questions are very very easy. You just have to take your factor equal to 0 and you just have to put the value of x in the expression. You will have the answer. Now we will solve these terms. So by solving these terms, our answer is 3. So the remainder is not equals to 0. So we will say that x minus 3 is not the factor of p of x. So this is the complete solution of question number 3.